Yes, my name is Peter Squires. I'm a professor in criminology and public policy at the University of Brighton. I work on criminology and public policy. That's to say I'm interested in crime and the causes of crime, but equally looking for the policies to do something about it. My recent work has been looking at young people and gun crime, and even more recently been getting a lot of people wanting work done on the so-called knife crime epidemic that parts of the country are going through. And the other area has become much more popular recently, the whole question of antisocial behaviour, which we've generally invented in Britain over the past decade. There are lots of things to be said about the way in which the media represents the problem of youth crime. For instance, a lot of the recent concerns about young people and violence has focused on young people and often young black people in cities, seeming to suggest that the major violence problems are about young people, when it plainly isn't. Young people are only a minor element of the problem. Yes, violence levels are going up, but knife crime is primarily an adult issue. It's a white issue. The crime reflects the social composition of the neighbourhoods in which it occurs. Similar kinds of issues came to light in relation to gun crime. For a long time, before we got a real handle on it, about a half of the gun crime committed in this country was committed with things like this, replica guns, not even real ones. Now things like this are banned, and we can take a proper look at what the scale of the problem. It isn't that our communities are awash with real guns, rather that we weren't dealing with some of the side issues around imitation firearms in Britain. There was one real spark that, for me, the pieces of research came together. We were doing a project in Brighton looking at victims of burglary. And quite by chance, I came across lots of houses in this area that had air pellet holes in doors and windows. And two or three people we spoke to about the burglary and the fear of crime problem on this particular estate said they had bought air rifles and showed them to us. I've bought this to protect myself. And it made me wonder what was going on. And it struck me that fear of crime is driving people to buy guns. It's the same phenomenon. Young people are carrying knives because they fear the world around us becoming more dangerous. And yet they're doing something that is amplifying the problem. And that was a moment when a lot of it came together for me, that if we didn't do something about people's underlying fears and concerns about crime, the perception of society as increasingly dangerous is going to lead us to take steps that I think we will end up regretting. There are a number of areas that I'm currently working on and developing. One is in relation to police armed response. It's a bit of a spin-off from some work I did a while ago. I did some interviews with armed response officers in Sussex. I watched them training some armed response officers, and now I'm hoping to take that further and look at the development of armed response policy. In Britain, we seem to cherish the idea that we're an unarmed society and have an unarmed police force. And I think it's important to hang on to that. So looking at the steps we've taken to go the other way in the context of concerns about violence, I think is an important issue.